Jackson, and we're back again for another video for all of our fellow newbie real estate investors, especially if you're in the area of wholesaling. So we want to talk to you a little bit about a few things today. We're going to talk to you about how to wholesale and keep your deals going even when you're on vacation, because if you're new to this, you should never be on vacation until you've built up to where you want to be. There is no vacation for you. The second thing we want to talk about is the importance of communicating to family and friends that you're going to be in real estate investing. And we'll talk to you about an opportunity that we missed out because we didn't communicate this with our family and friends. So if this video interests you, we hope that you stay tuned. So Dad, can you tell us a little bit about where we are, why we're here, and what we've been doing to continue to support our real estate investing business while we're on vacation?
Yeah, okay. We're on vacation in South Carolina. We drove actually from Houston to our vacation point. And along the way, while being on vacation, it's fun. You're having a good time with your family. But we're still looking at opportunities to make cash, make money. And with that being said, what was important about this trip is not only seeing family and having a good time, but are there any opportunities that we might find along the way? So as we got to our destination, we started to see bandit signs. And that kind of just opened up our mind, like, okay, yeah, we are on vacation, have a good time, but why not seize an opportunity while it's right in front of us? And if you're getting, like, we're still hungry, even though we're on vacation, to take a property and make something very profitable of it. So, and we did that. We ended up driving for dollars yesterday, and found out that there were about 7 houses that were either vacant or had been foreclosed on. The best part about it was when we looked up the information, it was well within a range that was affordable for anyone getting started.
Talk about when you say look it up. What do you want to tell them a little bit about the app that we use?
Go ahead.
I'll tell you about it. It's called My REI Pro. It's by Mr. Golf. I forgot his first name, but he's with Bigger Pockets. The app is expensive. It's very expensive. It's like $150 a month, but the first month is free. You get a free month trial, and basically it's an all-inclusive app for real estate investing. So once you plug in the address, it'll tell you the tax details, the mortgage details, the history of the home, like who owned the home, you know, since it was built. It'll tell you how much is owed on the home. It'll give you the comps. It'll show you a picture of the house. It'll also help you skip trace and find names and phone numbers. It already has contracts in there for you. It already has mailers, different examples of postcards and letters. It has scripts on there. Pretty much everything that you need to get started is already there in a nice, neat package. So when he says we looked up the property, that's the app that we use to look up the property.
And then, finding out that information, there were some really nice deals up there that we looked at, and we're like, okay, it got to a point where we were like overflowing with opportunities coming in. So of course, while on vacation, we're in the back of our minds, we're like, okay, can you pass this over? And the answer is no. Why not? Why pass over an opportunity like this when you're seeing multiple homes that you have an opportunity to invest in? So our vacation went from, okay, while on vacation, we're gonna turn that into a little time to invest in and do a little homework and find out what opportunity we can make out of driving for dollars while having a good time. Not only just driving for dollars, but we really did have a good time as we were on our journey through our vacation, but also finding out more information about homes that possibly be good leads. And then with contacting our family, they knew of, they had prior knowledge of us in our business. So they were able to not only show us properties that might be beneficial to us, but they knew some of the residents who own the properties, which was even a better deal for us because they had the phone numbers firsthand. So that was a plus. So the communication of letting people know what you're doing, especially with family, while being on vacation, is endless. So take advantage of that.
And let me tell you a few stories just to kind of piggyback on what Jackson was talking about. So yesterday we took our children to a water park, you know, we're parents first, and it began to rain. And so they said they weren't going to open the doors up for another 30 minutes. So we could have sat in the parking lot, but we were like, well, why don't we just go look at some houses? So literally it was like a small like parade, because we had three cars of our family showing us different properties, and we were following them. And as Britt mentioned earlier, you know, it's a very small town where we were. This is Hartsville, South Carolina. So a lot of the vacant properties were, as he said earlier, they belonged to friends of our family members. And the sweet part about it is, number one, we didn't have to pay for skip tracing to find the phone numbers. But number two, the rapport was already there, right? A big chunk of this is building rapport with the seller so that they want to sell to you. Well, the rapport was already done. I mean, you know, our grandmother has been, you know, in touch with these people for 65 years. They grew up next door to each other. So that made it a whole lot easier for us. Another story I'd like to share as well, we talked about the importance of communicating what you're doing to your family and friends. South Carolina is different from Texas. In Texas, you do have to go to auction to purchase the homes that are in tax foreclosure, unless you, of course, you go and, you know, door knock or meet with the seller first. But in South Carolina, you can go straight to the tax assessor's office, and if you pay up the taxes for that house, you own it. You don't even have to go through the seller, which is nice, right? Well, yes. So the house across the street from our grandmother was purchased for $2,000 in that manner. At the time, she didn't know that we were in real estate. We hadn't communicated that to her. And so we just kicked ourselves in the butt, because we could have had that house for $2,000 for paying up the back taxes, but because we had communicated what we were doing to our family and friends, we missed out on the opportunity. So in order for you to avoid the mistake that we made, just start telling everybody about it, even if you think they can't help you. One of our aunts owns a property in Hartsville, South Carolina, and it's boarded up, it's vacant, she's not doing anything with it. And now that she knows that we're in the business, well, now we have a lead. We already have a foot in the door. The seller is our aunt, our dear aunt, who loves us very much. So we're already in the process of figuring out which route she wants to go through. You know, do we put it subject to? Does she just want to give it to us for love and consideration? Or does she want us to do like a owner finance, you know, rent to own type of situation? The house is paid for free clear. But again, that's simply because we communicated to our family and friends what we were doing for real estate investing. So point number one, you're never on vacation. There is no break. You are new to this. You need to be obsessed with it. Everything that you do, every opportunity that you have to ride down any street, you are working. And then point number two, let your family and friends know what you're doing, because they can generate a lot of your best leads. And in a lot of instances, they already have rapport with the sellers, which already saves you a huge step. That's the most of your time is building rapport. Signing the contract takes 2 minutes.
And another thing along with that, I'm going to add another point if I could.
Yes, of course.
If what we didn't know was if you could go to the tax office here in South Carolina, that's something that would probably cut out of a lot of homework that you had, a lot of groundwork that you would do in a different state. So if states vary with how they handle certain things when it comes to investing, you might want to do your homework on it if you're planning on taking the trip or traveling to another country, another city or another state, and finding out, hey, how do they handle things when it comes to investing? If I wanted to find out information about a property, you know, what way do they particularly handle that situation? And just finding out, you know, will allow you to possibly cut out the middleman, so to speak, or, you know, exactly setting up an appointment to go visit the tax office so that you can find out what's available. And once you get there, you find the property, or even if you have a prior knowledge of what properties are available, and you set up a time where you can go to that tax office. And if you're prepared to make an investment, then that works for you. It's a win-win situation. So finding out a little bit about how each particular city or state on how they do things is very beneficial. So that was the point that I wanted to add to that. I thought that was a good idea.
For sure. Well, if you like what you saw today, this is just the tip of the iceberg. We're going to do this often, at least 2 or 3 times a week. Our next video is going to be our shopping haul on how to do marketing on a budget. We'll kind of talk to you about what we use for marketing. We'll be very honest with you about how much we paid, how much we saved, and who we went through. And then we're also going to finally do an introductory video. A lot of people have reached out to us and wondered how long we've been married, how long have we been doing